So Fabio, thank you so much for sitting down with us. Firstly, how are you and how was your summer?
My summer was busy, as every summer. So this summer is a bit different because World Cup in 2 months' time, so different dynamics in the transfer window, but everything fine. So happy about the start of the season, at the beginning of the season.
Yeah, it's been a good start, huh? From a Spurs fan's point of view.
We are happy, so we are just at the beginning, so we have to continue like this, be focused, be committed in our job, and to make the fans happy.
Do you want to give me your overall assessment of how we got on in the transfer window? How do you look at the summer as a whole from a transfer point of view?
From my point of view and Tottenham point of view, it was a really good summer, good transfer window. First of all, we have to thankful Enic to help us about the equity injection early in June, so give us the opportunity to make our job in the right way, easy, without economically difficult, and we were all together to join our targets, and so lucky to join our targets early, so give the players ready for pre-season with Antonio, so work with the teams. Everything was good.
When you're watching players warm up and you see the level of depth that we have now, you can really see that across the board we've got such strength, haven't we?
The team is much balanced, and then the work that Antonio made in this year was amazing. I want to thankful even the staff for this kind of work every day, focus. So we are much better, and we don't have to forget this. Hope so in 1 year time to be here and say we are much better again. So this is when I came here 1 year ago. If you remember, my first word was we have to be better, we have to build something important and arrive to be competitive. I think we are in good place. Maybe the gaps is reduced. Maybe, you know, we finish from the table 20 points less than Liverpool and Man City, so the gaps is not possible to reduce this kind of gaps in small time, but we are much better.
So was it a strategic decision to try and get business done early to help bridge that gap?
To do the thing early is just about a question of, as a vision, the same vision with the club, the coach, so everyone together and make the right decision and straight away to find out our targets.
And I suppose for Antonio, it's enormously helpful to be able to spend more time in pre-season, to take players on tour as well and become immersed within the squad.
Yeah, I think so, not just for Antonio. For every coach, it's important to have this kind of solution. So to get the player early, you can work and you can manage them, you can know better them, so it's easy. Sporting side, economic side, and even, I think, give a right signal to everyone, players, fans, other school, other clubs. We know what we have to do and we follow our line. That's it.
How much do you think the fact that we've got Champions League football again back in N17 makes a difference when you're going out to do your work?
First of all, because when you are in Champions League, you get a bit, for the club is really important, about brand, about, of course, money, and even to be attractive for players, because every player in the world won't play Champions League. So I know that in England it's very difficult to get in the first four, to arrive in the first four in the Premier League. You can imagine for the other clubs in England, it's something special to get to the first four. But even for us, has to be a target, continued target, and I don't want to say normal target, but it has to become habit to play Champions League. Every player that arrives is agreed between me, Daniel, the coach, and the coach knows every player and knows Ivan particularly because he training him in Inter. So then with Ivan, it's not so difficult to present him because he's a big player. He's playing so in a lot of leagues, different leagues. He's an intelligent guy. So because he speaks a lot of languages. So even the entering one group is easier for him. Clemente played a lot of matches in Barcelona. So when one player stay in Real Madrid or Barcelona or Bayern Munich or, you know, this kind of clubs, there is a reason why stay for a long time in this club. So we are happy to have him in our squad.
Let's talk a little bit about Richarlison. He's someone already that is incredibly popular. How much have you enjoyed watching him so far? And why were you so keen to bring him in so early?
We are so convinced to buy him so far, because this kind of style of football is, I think, perfect for us. About not just about technically speaking, about character. So he's a fighter, he's someone that he has a big energy, he can play in three positions in the forward. So he's someone that has great spirit in Premier League and in national team of Brazil. So I think it's really easy, technically speaking, choice him. Fraser is someone that he play a lot of matches, Premier League matches, Champions League matches, national team matches. So he's someone that, and he's a guy that he has a big enthusiasm. He help a lot everyone. And will be very helpful for us in the group, but I'm sure that even he showed in the past that as big, a great goalkeeper.
We've spoken a bit about competition for places, and it's particularly obvious in midfield with Eve coming in now as well. Another player with enormous quality, but a lot of experience as well, that will challenge for one of those two midfield spots.
Yeah, so Bissouma has some different skills to our midfielders because he's more 1v1, technically speaking, can even shoot from the distance. So it's a bit different about the skills. Then he has to enter in our mechanism because the team now is really well organized, super organized. So come in is not easy for the players, need a little bit time to adapt.
I think one of the things, you mentioned the young players, I think one of the things Spurs fans love is the idea of a young player building his journey here. So we signed a couple of exciting young players this summer with Destiny and with Jed. How excited are you for those guys to start their journey?
Yeah, so if we sign player because we believe a lot in these players, so Destiny staying Udinese 1 year more on loan, and the others as Sar, Spence, even don't forget Brian Gill because he's really younger. But we have other players younger because the people forget that sometimes that Sessegnon, Emerson, Romero, Kulusevski are just 21 or 22 years older. And so I think this group of players, someone is more ready because lucky to play more matches before at the beginning of their career, and someone is less ready because arrive from, for example, Spence from Championship or Sar from Metz. This so is different for is difficult is a bit more difficult for them.
Yeah, you forget that Cuti Romero is so young as well with the way that he performs, but so special to know that he's going to be at the club now till 2027.
So sometimes we don't have the perception how younger are these players. And for this reason, they need work. So for this reason, we have to remember how good is the Antonio job in the last year. Because, you know, when you have players so with this age, you have to work more. Is normal, and we have repeat player like Romero, Emerson, Sessegnon, Kulusevski, Bentancur, Skippy, so play a lot of matches.
We're at the end of your third transfer window. Feels like the time has whizzed past. How do you reflect on the first three transfer windows, and where do you think we're at in terms of your longer term vision?
We have to be proud and happy what we did in the last year, so get Champions League. We have Antonio Conte coach, is one of the most bigger coach in the world. We sign players, we improve players. That is another big achievement for us. But we have a long way in front of us. So we start to be more competitive, but it's not enough. We want to be better, as I said before. Every day we have to achieve what we have in our mind. So be better and be better as a club, be better as a person, be better as professional. And I think this club now is in the right direction.